at the top. Can't be sloppy, man. Can't make no mistakes. I seen some of the richest dudes fall off, get backdoored, and go to jail. Even worse, die. Me and my brother been in the game for a couple years now. And on this day, everything fucked up. Everything changed. Terry didn't know. Neither did I. Man, it's just surrounded, man. 5-0 SWAT team, helicopters, the whole 9 yards, man. I don't know how we was gonna get out of this. So we start shooting back. I wasn't learning to take me alive, man. I already know what's gonna happen. You ever have that feeling in your gut? You know you shouldn't be doing something. Just do it anyways. Yeah. That was me right here. Getting in a shootout with police? In my 28 years of being on this earth, man, I had no clue this was gonna be the case. All I knew was I wanted to make it out here alive. I know for sure I was going to. I had probably like 2 more clips left, man. I was not going out. I told Terry, go get the helicopter in the back, man. Go start it up. Because we ain't making it out of this alive if we stay in here, man. At this point, they got us pinned down. I'm just giving out all I got. I only have 1 more clip left, man. I think Terry was prepared for this. But I wasn't. Wasn't at all. Probably wondering how it ended up like this and where we gonna go. I'll tell you. So here's my story. My name is Brandon Jenkins. Everybody just call me Breeze. See, I'm Ballers family. I've been born and raised, but I was gifted. I was great at track, so I got a scholarship to ULSA. Just been trying to stay out of trouble, man. That's Mr. Rogers. Be a little annoying, but try to keep me on the right track. I've been fucking with her since freshman year, but there ain't been a chance. Yeah, sure, you're gonna give me a shot one day, though. Just watch. None of those rich kids could see me on the track. I'm dusting them every single time. Couldn't even be in my heat. It's crazy. Coach, if I try a little harder, I might be able to make the Olympic team. I'm just gonna keep training. Hustle. Gotta make it out the hood, man. Los Santos ain't for me. At least the hood ain't. I know there's a lot more in this world I need to see. Gotta get out of here. Make something for myself. You feel me? This is really the turning point of everything, honestly. Looking back. It was really just a regular day, though. Shit felt a little eerie, though. So, just got off of track practice. High class, got some shit I was gonna work with. This is a smoke show. Ain't gonna work with. Shit. Craziest part about being from the streets, it don't matter where you at, beef is gonna follow you. If you at school, work, party, don't matter. Shit, I just got off of class. I was feeling real strange, man, like I was being watched. Before you know it, IS-300 with some grocery niggas rolled up on me, pulled a stick out, asked me where my phone. Shit, I told him. Ballers family, Davis Street. You already know? That wasn't the answer he liked. He upped that shit. Before you know it, I took off. The driver skirted off, threw in the back seat, let off some shots. Hit me in the leg, hit me in the chest. My season was over. My track dreams crushed. Craziest part about it is, I probably even know them niggas. They just see me wearing purple. Shit, it was a miracle I even made it. Doctor said I lost a gallon of blood. Now I gotta start from the ground up. No more school, no more track. All I know is a hood. Shit, I hope I gotta make some shit. Some gotta give. I'm not trying to be up in here forever, man. Shit. Terry's story is completely different from mine. He was a menace to society, product of his own environment. On his day, he decided to jack old man Wu's convenience store up the street. Big mistake. Hey man, we had a lot of cop phones, so robbing his store is a bad idea. Terry was desperate at the time. He was his son. But old man Rudy knew he wasn't finna lose his life over a couple $100. He ended up hitting Mr. Wolf side the head, upgraded his charge on aggravated robbery. Had to do more time upstate. Shit crazy. Old man Rudy got knocked the fuck out that day. Cops was on his ass. He was doing 5 years in prison. Shit crazy. Whole hood changed when he left. See, Terry a hothead, but he ain't a dumb nigga. He know his strengths, he know his weaknesses. That's crazy. It's like, he went to prison with a GED at crime. He came out with a master's. Guess when you doing time up there, man, you got nothing else to do but perfect your craft. Shit crazy. Nobody was writing, bro, putting money on his books, but me. So you know I had to pick him up from prison when he jumped. A lot of shit changed since he went in. Since I got shot. Shit. Even the whole hood changed, to be honest with you. And Terry had to put on like 20, 30 pounds in that motherfucker, bro. Nigga was looking aki as hell. Shit, I gotta catch up. I was glad to see my cousin, though. I ain't seen him in a couple years, man. I didn't know what to expect, to be honest with you. I just knew we had to get to this money. And keep it a buck with you, after sure. I've been stagnant, man. I ain't been on the same shit like I used to be. Shit, hopefully Terry being back in town, we can get shit back on the right foot. I always knew I was gonna run it up in something. Whether it was gonna be track or these bags, I'm gonna run it up. Shit, when Terry came home, the whole hood was different. Everything changed. Shit wasn't like it used to be. My granny passed away a couple years ago. She left us a crib. A little trap spot, I guess you could say. Something we could rest our heads at. Fresh start. So I don't got a dollar to my name. Terry just got out. I know he broke too. So we gotta figure out something. Cause rent due, these lights finna get turned off real soon. A big homie switch, front of Terry jump. Let's see if we can put in some work. Like I said, Terry a hothead. And that's somebody you need on your team. Somebody don't give a fuck. And that's just the man that he is.
Top of the morning, cuz. What we getting into, Sean?
Same shit, different
word, word. You don't mind if I hit this right quick, right?
Go ahead, bro.
All right, bet. Say less.
For sure, right there.
Shit, nigga, I can see that.
On a serious note, though, bro, we gotta get to some money, bro. I don't got a dollar to my name.
Shit.
I know you broke as a joke.
Shit, nigga. What? You shitting me, bro? Nigga, it's hard out here, but I'm trying to see what's up with niggas on the block, you heard? What we doing, Sean?
Hey, bro, a big homie Switch want to meet up today, bro.
Okay.
He want to see if you still get down. He heard about you, bro.
Shit, nigga, that's easy, brody.
All right, we going to do something then. All right. Make some shape. Davis Street, Baller's family, it's completely different now, man. It's not how it was when I was growing up. There's a lot of young niggas that's wilding out here trying to get their respect. A couple niggas at the top just watching it all happen. One of the top ballers, his name is Switch. They call him Switch because this nigga be switching in and out of cars every week. You might see him in the Benz this week, you might see him in the Escalade next. You just never know. Like I said, Terry's a hothead, and Switch wanted to use that for his advantage. Shit, I don't blame him. There's his Vagos cat. His name Carlos, right up the block. Moving mad weight, messing up Switch business. Him being out the way helps shit move real smooth. That's when me and Terry come into play. 20 bands for Carlos' head. See, if we lived in South Los Santos and you was puffing on some Za, it for sure came from Carlos. They was running that projects like the military, armed to the teeth. The Vagos didn't play. But neither did me or Terry. Who was down for whatever? Who was masked up, strapped up, ready to go to war? Me and Terry hopped in the car, we drove down to the projects. The moment we see Carlos, it's on sight. Pull in this little alleyway real quick, stake out the scene, make sure everything cool. They was outside today, dozens of them. I know they was strapped. I don't got nothing else to lose though. So you gonna spin the block one more time. Make sure my gloves is on, mask is tight, And I was locked and loaded. And ain't no woes about to hit him. Probably just a regular day for him. This is my first drill, so I'll be lying if I said I wasn't scared. But I know I gotta do what I gotta do for Brawler's family. Carlos' perspective, like I said, it was just a regular day for him. Just handling business in the hood, politicking, you know, regular shit. I heard a lot of stories about Carlos, that he was a cartel leader's son. They sold $1 million worth of Zion one day. Shit, I don't know what to believe. But I do know he about to get smoked. I started letting off his shots. He took off. Terry hopped in the car, tried chasing. And I took him on foot. Shots are going down, everybody's scattering. He hopping fences, I'm hopping gates. Shit crazy right now. All I know is I'm finna find his ass and smoke him. Run behind the projects, cutting through, hop that gate. Went across the street, hopped another one. That's when Terry pulled up. We had Carlos cornered. I guess his gun jammed, because he gave up as soon as we seen him. Knocked him right upside the head with my shit. He woke back up, so get your ass in the trunk. He was playing though. So I had to push him in that motherfucker. Get your ass in there, bro. And Terry closed the trunk. He told me he know a spot we could take him. Honestly, this shit went smoother than I expected it to go. Might be the easiest 20 bands we ever made. Shit. Terry said he knows this little junkyard factory a couple miles up the way. Gonna take him here and handle this business. Carlos in the trunk. He was kicking and screaming. So he just moved to the front seat, me in the back. Terry knew about the old Rogers factory over on the east side. It was abandoned. So we headed that way to go finish our business. I ain't gonna lie though, Carlos a tough one. I ain't hear no fear in his voice. I see scared in his eyes. Staring down a barrel of a gun was one of the craziest things that I've been through. It's crazy how it's not even phasing him. We got here. What are we talking about? Thinking new ways fate was. This is it. I'm gonna catch my first body. Then Carlos said, how much they paying you for this? Terry told him, 20 bands. Carlos started chuckling. He said, you think my life only worth 20 bands? Can make you 20 million before the year ends. That point, yeah, me and Terry curious. That's what Carlos said. I ain't even a real plug. I could put you on. You let me go, I'll put you on to the real plug. That's when I seen Terry's eyes light up. I asked him, how can I trust you? He told me, there's really no way you could trust me. But I could put you on, make some money in the meantime, in between time until we meet the plug. He already knew we was ballers, so he was willing to tell us where Grove Street keeps their stash. Everything that he was saying sounded amazing. Still a little hesitant though. But I'd rather take 20 million in a year, get 20,000 for killing somebody. We agreed. Next week, we finna meet the plug. But I told Carlos, you gotta lay low. Ballers family think you gone, and I can't have them thinking that you're still out here. I told him, the only way I'm gonna let you leave here is if I have some insurance. He gave me the Addy to his condo downtown. Shit, that's good enough for me. I guess we're gonna meet the plug next week. Me and Terry hit a switch. Told him that the hit was done. Told us to meet him at the supermall. Real eerie feeling meeting him here though. I ain't gonna lie. Word get around quick. And I was scared he found out we lied about the hit. We lied that Carlos is still alive. We just gotta play our cool. What else can we do? Shit crazy though. I heard Switch Hellcat injured from about 3 blocks down the street. He one of the only dudes in the hood with a Hellcat. So I respect it. He pulled it to the Davis Mega Mall, you feel me? All time per usual. Switch be about his business. Can't blame him. I be about mine too. So what's up to us? Told Terry put down that blunt. Hop in the car. Not gonna lie, kinda nervous. Switch's partner, man, they was asking us all types of questions. Where's the body? What gun we use? I told him, if that Switch right here, I'm just gonna keep it real, to be honest with you. Ain't no point in lying. Switch counted out about 20 bands, put it in the backpack, handed it to me. Made sure to count it myself, too. It's the most money I ever seen in my life. I don't even know what I'm finna do with it. I hop out the car, say my goodbyes, tell him thank you, dap switch up, dap man up, we on our way. Like I said, one of the easiest 20 bands I ever made. Shit, that was the only 20 bands I ever made. I'm finna go to Rodeo and get some drip. Shit. We're going out tonight for real, for real. We up, boys.
A rat is a traitor, a conceiver, planner, or physical participator. He doesn't sell secrets for power or cash. He betrays the trust of his team or his family, hoping to save his own cowardly ass. The difference is, at least a snitch is human, but a rat is a rat.
So apparently, Man was on his last strike. Got caught a couple guns in his car. Looking to do about 15 years. But he throwing anybody under the bus, including me, Terry, and Switch. Him and Detective McGuire met up at the gas station later that night. Told him everything about the meeting, about the 20 bands, about Carlos being dead. That was the moment me and Terry got on LSPD's radar. If I knew what I knew now, I would have blew his brains out when I was sitting in that back seat.